go for it.
All right, let's jump into it then. So, Ninja, this guy, does anyone, do you two know who Ninja is?
See, I actually keep getting Ninja confused with that guy that's in prison, that Takeshi 69.
Like when the rapper.
I don't know why. I swear, yeah. Everyone's like talking about his ninja guy. I'm like, is that him in prison that keeps like grassing on everyone? So yeah, that's how much I know.
Okay, yeah, well, it's a bit different to the hardcore rapper that is Takeshi 69. Ninja is the biggest gaming streamer in the world. He broke all records on the amount of like concurrent views at one time playing games. The amount, like, he was one of the quickest growing people on YouTube. Do you know who he is, Joe?
Yeah, I know who he is. I read something somewhere and he said that he earned at one point something like 500 grand a month just from streaming on Twitch.
Oh my lord.
But he's moved to Mixer now.
Yes, yeah. So there was a big thing in the online world recently where he came off Twitch, which was the streaming platform he started with. Do you know what Twitch is?
Yeah.
The big, huge streaming platform. He left Twitch and signed up to Mixer, which was Microsoft's new platform to compete with Twitch, Microsoft's game streaming platform. And there was a huge commotion in the streaming world. Twitch did a load of backhanded dirty things and said a lot of things about Ninja once he left, and there was a bit of commotion going around there. So yeah, he got a bit of news attention there.
Did he get paid to go across to the Microsoft one?
He did, yeah. And it was
money talks,
undisclosed amount, but you can imagine it, if it's Microsoft paying it as well,
yeah,
it's gonna be a huge amount of money.
It'd be a good amount.
And I actually saw an interview about that in the past where he was like, rightly so, he was like, you know, we are the new generation of names, you know, leaders on the internet. They should be getting these exclusive deals and getting paid to be on these platforms.
It's almost like a sports contract, and it's like when like a big football player gets signed to Nike or whatever. Like, it's exactly the same thing, which is frankly amazing, to be honest, that goes on.
Have you ever heard of IRL streaming?
No.
There's a guy out there called Ice Poseidon, and then there's a few others that do it as well. And they just basically walk around the streets with a live streaming camera and do different stuff. So people tip them to do things, and they'll go into places. And when they tip them, it'll play a noise out loud. Mm-hmm. And there's been some pretty bad things that have happened. Someone's gone to prison for something that happened.
Can the viewer choose the noise that's played?
Yeah, like, so they just, when they tip, a noise will come out of the microphone that they've got. So if they've got a speaker held, one guy was in a school and it was a bomb that went off. It was like bomb detonating in 10, 9,
no way.
8. And everyone ran out of the room. And I think he went to prison for that, didn't he?
I didn't hear about that story, but I saw one guy who was in a supermarket and his viewers were donating money to him and making these like really awkward sounds played. I can't remember exactly what he was saying, but everyone in the queue at the supermarket was looking at him.
Asian Andy, that is, yeah.
Was it? Yeah. And it was like proper awkward. So IRL streaming, it stands for in real life. Right, so that's a whole branch of streaming. But what Ninja does is he does gaming streaming. And like I said, he's the biggest gamer in the world. So he has actually broke new grounds. I don't know if you've heard this story yet, you two, but the game Fortnite, which must be the biggest game in the world now, if not one of them. It makes so much money every year. So the game Fortnite has actually decided to honor Ninja by giving him his own character in the game Fortnite. Yeah, his own skin. We jump over to the video that Ninja just released. We can see.
All right, well, I guess people are tweeting about it and posting about it. So we'll talk about it, baby. It happened. It's official. We finally got a ninja skin.
He's so excited.
In the game.
So a skin is another name for a character.
We did it. It took 2.5 years. I streamed like 12 hours a day minimum, basically.
How long? 12 years, is it?
12 hours a day.
12 hours a day for 2.5 years.
Accumulated billions of views on YouTube and on streaming platforms.
Let's pause a second. So Ninja has been live streaming games for 10 years now, 9, 10 years. Yeah. But he's been playing Fortnite for 2.5 years. Like you said, 12 hour a day, like, it's a full-time job. Like, that's a lot of work. It's not graft.
It looks in pretty good nick, to be honest. I expected him to be like a slot, like Jabba the Hutt, you know?
Yeah.
Like, he don't look in bad shape.
He's become like the poster boy of gaming and game streaming because for that reason, like, he looks like a normal guy.
Yeah, you kind of think they're going to look, it would look like the South Park characters, you know? You know what I mean? Yeah.
The guy on the World of Warcraft. Yeah. I think that's one of the reasons he's got so big is because corporations have really jumped on board of having him as a brand ambassador for their companies. Like, there's a Red Bull fridge in the back. He's sponsored by Red Bull. Like, he's the reason why.
I don't think he's ever done anything wrong either, has he?
No.
Lot of other streamers have done things wrong.
Yeah, we spoke about it last episode.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. And he's not.
So, and like he said, he like billions of views he collects, you know, for these games. So this is like a milestone in the gaming community where they're actually getting acknowledged and getting sort of rewarded and for what they're doing for these companies. Like I said, Mixer, Microsoft paid them tons of money, you know, because by him moving from Twitch to Mixer, he's bringing potentially billions of views to their new platform. And by him playing Fortnite for 2.5 years, 12 hours a day, think of all the new customers, like the new gamers that have started playing Fortnite because they watch him.
Yeah. It's actually amazing. I've never played Fortnite. Have you played Fortnite?
I've had a quick go on it, yeah.
I did. I played it for a little bit. I got okay at it, but then everyone just starts going past you and they're all really, really good. My friends got really good at it and I just can't keep up. So
it's one of the things that when a new Call of Duty comes out or anything like that, I'm scared to actually start playing it because I don't want to lose any, like 12 hours a day. Like I remember when I used to play Call of Duty back when I was younger and I'd come home from school, get on live, you know, on the, where you could play online against your mates and I'd lose hours of my life. And I'm scared that if I do that now, like, obviously we've got businesses and stuff to run.
Yeah, so I'm exactly the same. Like, I've been fighting off the temptation to buy a console for about 3 years, you know, like, because I know I'll fall down that same hole with it that you're talking about.
I bought Red Dead Redemption 2 and I've not opened it. Like, I've had it, it's like there for...
That's about a 60-hour game as well.
That's a good game, though. It's worth the 60 hours.
I put it in the thing, with the snow, like, you start off in the snow, don't you, on the... Yeah. And I was like, no, I can't do it, and took it back out, so I've not touched it since.
Well, let's jump back into Ninja and see what he says then after this.
Fortnite had the best time of my gaming career in life.
He's seriously happy about this.
Hashtag Ninja Skin is in the game and I get to show it to you guys.
Cool, pause that then. So the way Fortnite works as well, I think the business model is the game's free, but then you play for skins and visual additions to your characters. So like there's little downloadable packs that you pay for. So I'm not sure. I think the Ninja Skin you probably have to pay for as well. But yeah, that's the way. That's one of the reasons it's the biggest game in the world. It's because it's free, but you just have to pay for additions inside the game.
Yeah, I've heard some horror stories. Well, I've read some articles about it where kids have got hold of credit cards and absolutely smashed it. And I've read articles of kids doing it on the App Store and stuff like that. Because I think when you buy something on the App Store, buy an upgrade on the App Store, it's like leaves it open for 15, 20 minutes. So they'll be like, oh, mum, can I have this? And like, yeah, all right, you can have the one. And they go upstairs and just smash it.
Oh, God.
Yeah. A couple of my friends that have played have spent maybe $1,000 on skins that don't do anything. They're just what something looks like. And the battle pass is pretty cool because you unlock things. You actually are working towards unlocking stuff. Whereas a skin, you buy a skin and then that's it.
Yeah, it gives you no advantage in the game. It just changes the way you look. Yeah, but I just think it's a great moment. Like, it's really acknowledging how big this type of online business model, like, is. This business model was growing, and how it's great that they're getting recognition. Jump to the next clip. I've got a few, Joe. We actually see him unveiling the skin and playing with it for a little bit. Just thought it'd be cool to see what it looks like. Cool. So yeah, here we go. Let's have a look.
Time for skin. Me.
So for our audio listeners, it's got like the blue hair that Ninja's got, and he's got like this.
Oh my god!
He's got this cool outfit on. He's got the red ball logo next to him.
Oh my god!
Shop Team Ninja there. Look, get your merch.
Yeah, and he's got like there's alternative versions, so he can wear like a bandana on one of them.
Oh my god!
It's pretty cool,
bro. Look at that. It looks just like me.
That is cool. That.
It must be cool to see yourself in one of the biggest games in the world. Yeah, and just because you play the game yourself.
They did the Fortnite dance as well, didn't they? Where it was a competition, and people sent in dances for Fortnite, and then they put them in the game.
Oh yeah.
And this one kid, Orange Justice, I think it was called, and he created one of the dances, but he didn't actually get in the game. And everyone says he needs to get in the game. And eventually, they put him in the game. Just this kid that uploaded a video on YouTube saying, this is my Fortnite dance.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, because obviously the Fortnite dance has been the floss and all that sort of stuff's been going around for a while now, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Cool. So let's keep it rolling. Let's move on. I just thought it'd be cool to acknowledge that sort of milestone that's been hit in the gaming community, in the streaming community.